From our nation's capital, please welcome the United States Army Band Pershing's Own under the baton of our executive officer, Major Aaron Morris. General John J. Pershing ordered the formation of the United States Army Band as the premier musical organization of our nation's senior service. For 100 years, Pershing's Own has maintained a proud tradition of excellence performing here at home and around the world. From the grandeur of the Capitol steps and the White House lawn to the battlefields of World War II and the hallowed hills of Arlington National Cemetery, we use music to tell the Army story and honor the sacrifice of all those who have served our nation. The soldiers you see before you represent the unparalleled excellence found in the people who volunteer to serve our nation in uniform, continuing the common thread of selfless service woven through the tapestry of our American Army for more than 247 years. And now, please stand and join Master Sergeant Tracy Labreck in the singing of our national anthem. Thank you. Welcome, and thank you for joining us this evening. My name is Staff Sergeant Carol Inglis, and I'll be your announcer for tonight's performance featuring the United States Army Band, Pershing Zone's Concert Band. What we just heard was Let Freedom Ring by Ryan Nolan, a stirring fantasy on the famous patriotic song, My Country, 'Tis of Thee. Up next is a march written in honor of General John J. Jack Black Pershing. If that name sounds familiar to you, it's because he's the person who we're named after. This week, we celebrated General Pershing's 162nd birthday, and we felt that it would only be appropriate to give him a little musical birthday shout out this evening. Here is Fred Huffer's Blackjack March, conducted by Chief Warrant Officer Benjamin McMillan. In theme with music from the early 20th century and in honor of General Pershing's birthday, we wanted it to feature a medley of famous World War I tunes. Today, we feature U.S. Army chorus singers Master Sergeant Tracy Lebreck and Sergeant First Class Matthew Richardson on Songs and Ballads of World War I, arranged by Beth C. Huff.
There were some and foam with all hillside country found them ready at the stirring call for men. Let no tears add to their hardship as the soldiers march along. And although your heart is breaking, let it sing this cheery song. Keep the home fires burning while your hearts are yearning. Though your lands are far away, they dream. Silver lining through the dark cloud shining. Turn the dark cloud inside out till the boys come home. It's a long way to Tipperary, it's a long way to go. It's a long way to Tipperary, to the sweetest girl I know. Goodbye, Piccadilly, farewell, Leicester Square. It's a long, long way to Tipperary, but my heart's right there. Up to mighty London came an Irishman one day. As the streets are paved with gold, sure everyone was gay, singing songs of Piccadilly, Strand and Leicester Square, till Paddy got excited and he shouted to them there. It's a long way to Tipperary, it's a long way to go. It's a long way to Tipperary, to the sweetest girl I know. Goodbye, Piccadilly, farewell, Leicester Square. It's a long, long way to Tipperary, but my heart's right there. Thank you.
Let's give it up for Chief McMillan and our singers, Sergeants Lebreck and Richardson. A military band concert wouldn't be complete without at least one march by America's March King, John Philip Sousa, right? Sousa composed Fauché Tower Washington Memorial March in 1929 for the grand opening of Wilbur B. Fauché's 32-story building in Minneapolis. Unfortunately, this piece was never performed at the event and was hidden away until 1976 when the Sousa family decided they were ready to release it to the public. Today, we perform for you John Philip Sousa's Fauché Tower Washington Memorial March.
Thank you.
What we just heard was Noisy Wheels of Joy by Eric Whitaker. Next, we have a very special treat for you. Today, we have the pleasure of showcasing our lead trumpet from the U.S. Army Blues, Staff Sergeant Joshua Kaufman. Hailing from Newcastle, Pennsylvania, Sergeant Kaufman joined us here at the U.S. Army Band in 2017 after receiving his bachelor's degree in jazz studies from the University of North Texas, where he performed with a Grammy-nominated 1 o'clock lap band. Yeah. Sergeant Kaufman regularly performs with the National Symphony Orchestra and the Kennedy Center Opera House and has shared the stage with the likes of Doc Severinsen, Hugh Jackman, and Frankie Valli in the Four Seasons. Tonight, our favorite jazz trumpeter performs a medley of Harry James hits. Here's A Tribute to Harry, arranged by Paul Murtha and featuring trumpet soloist Staff Sergeant Josh Kaufman.
Thank you.
Wasn't that amazing? Let's give another round of applause to Staff Sergeant Josh Kaufman. Now, who here is a Disney fan? How about the band Earth, Wind, and Fire? Yeah. Well, this evening, we feature both through the vocal stylings of Master Sergeant Tracy Lebrecht, Sergeants First Class Adiza Jabril and Matt Richardson, and Staff Sergeant Ethan Green. Feel free to sing along with us as we perform for you Michael Brown's Disney Movie Magic and Earth, Wind, and Fire's legendary song, September.
And unrefined, and now he's dear, and so I'm sure. I don't know why I didn't see it there before.
Tale as old as time, true as it can be.
Big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wet. Take it from me. Up on the shore they work all day. Out in the sun they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating under the sea. The duke play the flute, the carp play the harp, the place play the bass and they sound and sharp. The bass play the brass, the chub play the tub, the fluke is a duke of soul. The ray he can play, the ling's on the string, the trout rocking out in that fishy six. The smelt and the sprat, they know where it's at, and know that floaters float. Thank you. find that sardine begin the beginning. It's music to me. What do they got? A lot of sand. We got a hot crustacean band. Each little snail here know how to whale here. That's why it's hotter under the water. Yeah, we're in luck here, down in the muck here, under the sea. Our guest, put our service to the test. Tie a napkin round your neck, Sherry, and we'll provide the rest. Soup du jour, hot hors d'oeuvre, why we only live to serve. Try the grey stuff, it's delicious. Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all, this is France, and the dinner here is never second best. Go on and sit right down and take a menu out and be our guest. Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest. It's been years since we've had anybody here, and we're obsessed. If you're here with your ease, it's been years and years since.
See? one more round of applause for those fantastic voices, right? So good evening, everyone. I am Major Aaron Morris, the Executive Officer for the United States Army Band, and we are absolutely delighted that you have chosen to be here with us on this beautiful evening, and we hope that you're enjoying the music. So as you've heard, we are the United States Army Band Pershing's own, and this year is, in fact, our centennial year. Because as you've already heard, we were founded in 1922 by that man with that statue right over there, General John J. Pershing. So September 13th was General Pershing's 162nd birthday. So being that we are here at Pershing Park, and it was just his birthday, and he is the father of our Army Band, I want to take a moment to just tell you a little bit about the General. So in the history of the United States Army, and really the United States, there are two individuals who stand out. There's George Washington, who founded the Army and our nation, and then there is John J. Pershing, who reinvented the Army in World War I. George Washington and John J. Pershing are the only two individuals to ever be appointed to the highest rank in the U.S. military, and that is the rank of General of the Armies. For those of you familiar with military rank, that's about the equivalent of a six-star general. In Europe during World War I, John Blackjack Pershing was tasked to rebuild the army almost from scratch and to lead the American efforts in World War I. Ultimately, the American Expeditionary Force mobilized some 4.7 million men to serve in World War I, and the Americans that served there made the difference that led to Allied victory. While in Europe, General Pershing was so impressed with the musicians of the European armies that he directed the foundation of U.S. Army bands. And in 1922, as you've heard now, after the conclusion of World War I, John Pershing came back here and directed the foundation of our organization. And from that day, it has been our mission to fulfill Pershing's dream of being one of the most professional music organizations in the world. Today, General of the Army's John J. Pershing is buried on a hilltop in Arlington National Cemetery just across the river. His burial plot overlooks all of Washington, D.C. But more important to Pershing wasn't where it was located, but why it was located there. And that is because he is buried with his troops, the men who died and served with him in World War I. Pershing understood the importance of being with his soldiers and for recognizing the men that he served alongside. So in that spirit, that is why with our next selection, we would like to recognize all of those in the audience that have served this nation by performing the service songs of the United States. We ask that if you have served, or if your loved one has served, would you please stand and raise your hand? And if you're unable to stand, please raise your hands so that we may recognize you and thank you for what you have done for our nation. Because this is your Armed Services Salute.
Coast Guard.
The Army is ready for the call. We place our trust in thee. Through surf and storm and howling gale, high shall our purpose be. Semper Paratus is our guard, in our fame, our glory too. To fight, to save, or fight and die, I Coast Guard, we are for you.
United States Space Force.
Thank you.
United States Marine Corps. United States Army.
First to fight for the right and to bear the nation's might, and the army goes rolling along. Proud of all we have done, fight until the battle's won, and the army goes rolling along. And it's high, high, hey, the army's on its way. Now the Africaine is not as strong.
had to start again with just my family by my side. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the ones who died and gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the ones who died and gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Once again, I am Major Aaron Morris, the Executive Officer of the United States Army Band Pershing's Own. And on behalf of our Commander, Colonel Bruce Pulver, we would like to thank you so very much for being here with us this evening. We sincerely hope that you have enjoyed tonight's concert, but unfortunately, we only have one more selection for you. I'm sorry, I know. But before we close, we would like to thank a special member of our team, or members of our team. So you see us out here in the white uniforms performing, right? But what you might not notice, because they are so slick, is behind us, wearing all black, back here in the sound, wearing all black, is our tech crew, our sound support. They make this whole concert possible. So team, thank you so very much. We couldn't do it without you. I would also like to invite all of you to reach out to us. You can find us on all of the social medias. We have all of them. Or you can go to usarmyband.com and you can go there and you can send us a message. Also there, you will be able to find information about future performances and video content that I am sure you will enjoy. We love to hear from our audiences and we read each and every piece of feedback we receive. So we look forward to hearing from you. And now to conclude our concert this evening, and really there is no better way to conclude a concert than by performing our national march. That is John Philip Sousa's Stars and Stripes Forever. Thank you all. Thank you.
my